Guys, it's me and welcome back to the channel. Today, I'm getting my hands dirty for the first time. Right, follow me, we've got a cracker in today. Now this is a really old Porsche 911 Carrera 2. It's been sat in storage for about 10 to 15 years. The purchaser has purchased the vehicle now. He's brought it into us and we're about to start the upkeep and getting it back up to running again. It's a non-starter at the moment, but it's been tested for compression and stuff. So yeah, check it out and follow me. So guys, so here it is. Here's the 997 Carrera 2. We've got Tom working on it today. So we've started off with the fact that the fuel's stale. It's been sat for 15 years. So we're draining the tank, put fresh fuel into it. Now doing the plugs and the coils on this is not an easy task just because of the way that they're located. So we're on a mission at the moment to get those changed, get those replaced, put them back together again, and then change all the fluids and see if we can get it started up and then go from there with it. Like I say, it has been sat for 15 years, but surprisingly, it's still absolutely perfect. It's been dry stored. So I think this is going to be a good one. And I think the guy that's bought it is going to be, he's going to be really happy with it. So yeah, stay tuned. Oh, and don't forget, I always forget this. Make sure you like, subscribe and comment below. Bits here and stuff. It's a bit damp as well on that, so that's going to probably need a new oil cooler. You see here how that's wet?
Yep.
So that's oil that's seeping through. So that's definitely going to have to be changed. Okay, that's fine. Everything else seems to be all right. What did you want me to do here?
The plug on the top of it. Coil's in, just need to plug.
Right, that plugs on. That's fine. I'm just so surprised on how well it still looks, considering it's been sat for so long. I mean, you know, you've got some surface corrosion, but I mean, bloody hell, they really built these cars well. As they say, old is gold.
Just needs a plug on that one as well.
Okay. Okay, that's on. Put that on there. Have all the plugs been taken out and cleaned?
Yeah.
That's fine. Okie dokie. Okie dokie. Out on the pool tonight, Tom? Oh, I shouldn't say that, man. Yeah. So.
He's trying to keep busy. Busier than he usually is, isn't he?
Yeah.
Holding a blooming light.
I mean, you know, can you believe my hands are dirty?
Yeah, I know, mate. You can get even dirtier now. You can put that plug into there as well.
I didn't sign up to get dirty hands.
say that's that one. On there. Plugs in on that. The coil's in, sorry, just needs a plug.
Okay.
In the middle one.
Okay, that's that one. In. And then on to the next. Last but not least.
Sorry, you're gonna have to get me. I can't get my hands up in there.
Okay, let me just plug this last coil, pack it in, and then I'm good to go.
I think that one's on.
What doesn't help when you're working on stuff where it's bloody freezing?
Oh no.
In there? It's so cold.
Right, that's in as well. It's just the middle one there that needs doing now, mate.
Okay, so you can put the bolts into these ones.
Oh yeah.
And then I'll put the
it's the middle ones here.
Oh my gosh. That heater. You know what, you have to be still.
Well, do you reckon before we
to even benefit from any of the heat that comes from it.
Do you reckon before we do that, doing that, we start it to see, make sure?
No, you can't. You have to screw them down so it keeps on the coil.
Oh, I see, okay.
The thing is, a part of maintenance, whether they actually need changing or not, because they've been sat for such a long period of time, you're not ever doing anything that doesn't need to be done. Do you know what I mean? Like, coils and plugs are, you know, they're the heart of the maintenance. So it's good measures to do anyway.
These plugs are a lot thicker than the last ones, which is why they got bolts, but they didn't supply them with every single...
Didn't they?
No.
Well, they should have done.
There's only six. Three didn't.
What are they cutting costs these days? And look, taking a couple of bolts out.
Because they're a lot thicker.
Yeah.
The old bolts aren't going to reach.
So what we're going to have to do is, if we haven't got any,
yep,
we're going to have to phone back up and say we need another one because you haven't.
Need three more sets of bolts. Can you give us three?
All right, I'm going to have to phone and say, lads, what are you doing?
What's the crack?
Cutting costs here, are we? Why only giving us half the parts? Yeah, no, but these, you're fine. So if it's small enough, it will do it. So, right, so the 10 mil's no good. Here's that set.
You've always had to make good with small things and make use of them, haven't you, mate?
That's right. But not all. Cut that one, Cully. Cut that one.
There's a cut there.
That's the right one.
Yep.
That's the one.
You got your little spanner as well.
No. You had that last.
Yep.
It's here.
Yeah.
And do you know what they say? Righty tighty, left righty tighty, lefty loosey.
Yeah, they say lefty loosey, righty tighty.
Either way. Again, they just need to be pinch tight.
Not over tight, man.
Yeah, no, it's just, all it is just to hold it in place. Ooh.
Is it full external?
Yeah, no, that's fine. Do you need the light over there?
Is that fine?
Yep. That's fine. I mean, even the springs look brand new stuff. They were changed about 15 years ago.
The car was sat 20 years and now he's saying that it's
15 years. I said 15. Years. I said 15. Adding digits for no reason.
No, you said 20 years now.
No, I said I said 15. Yeah, beep, beep.
What was
more cuts for Gully. Actually, no, I better not do that. He billed me for that. Right, guys, that's a wrap. It's been an exhausting week, to say the least. Temperatures dropped, it's cold, but we battle on as usual. The Porsche concludes today. We've made a start with, as we said, with the coil packs and the spark plugs, and we've drained the fuel and we've drained the fluids. Next step for next week is to get it started, get it running, and then really go with what we find and carry on the journey, as I would say, in getting the car back up to a roadworthy condition, MOT'd, and then hopefully the new owner of that car can start using it. So it's been a productive week. The lads have certainly enjoyed working on an array of different cars. Now what we are going to do very, very soon is we're going to do a raffle where you might win a host of prizes. We haven't decided exactly what that is going to be yet, but do stay tuned. It's going to be worth a watch for definite. I hope that you find it entertaining and you keep on with the journey with us and what we're able to do and to entertain you on a daily basis. There's lots of laughs and jokes here, professional, unprofessional, it's great. And do not forget to please like, subscribe, share and comment and give us some feedback. Brilliant, stay tuned and we'll see you again soon.